Turning our attention now to the battle raging in Libya, and a coalition of Arab nations is calling on the UN to impose a no-fly zone. The White House today praising that move, which was pretty unexpected. Meantime, forces loyal to Muammar Gaddafi and his regime launching an air assault on rebels, driving them out of a key oil city. Ras Lanuf is the name of that city. And our own Leland Bittert is there when the bombs started falling. He joins us streaming live now from Benghazi in Libya. Leland.
Hi, Rick. As we were heading back from the front lines, our photographer Mal James and I were going to stop at our normal hotel only to find out that the hotel had closed because it wasn't safe to stay there. So we continued on here to Benghazi. And this comes as the rebels continue to give up mile after mile. Gaddafi is just pounding them with his heavy artillery, his tanks, and he's also coming in with his air force, largely a psychological effect as these bombing raids continue. But I can tell you from being on the ground with these rebels when the bombs fall, it's not a place you want to stick around.
Just went off right next to the checkpoint. We don't know if anybody's injured. Unbelievable. This is the second day in a row they have hit this checkpoint. You can see the smoke coming across. Everybody now running for cover. It was just 5 minutes or so ago that we were down at this checkpoint and moved back here for safety. We got another air attack right out there. Earlier, Gaddafi bombed this town here of Agela, and you can see where the bomb just got dropped right out there. Some anti-aircraft fire going up now. The plane is gone. You can see, though, where it ended up, the bomb right out there. Looks like they missed this time.
And it seems as though the novelty of this revolution has worn off for the population. Even here in the rebel-controlled towns, there is a tension now that you have that you didn't have 2 weeks ago when we arrived. At one point, it seemed like the rebels were almost drunk, sort of with exuberance at how wonderful things were going to be and how they were just going to march on to Tripoli. Hasn't worked out that way, and now everyone's asking themselves, what if Gaddafi is able to come back through here with the savagery that he has promised? Clearly overthrowing this dictator of 41 years, Rick, has been a whole lot harder than anyone here in the eastern part of Libya ever expected. Rick, back to you.
Well, he's got quite a war chest. Leland Vittert live for us in Benghazi, Libya. Leland, thanks. Be careful out there.